showing up or doing something that who cares? I want to tell you, heaven cares about it. Heaven cares about it. And until you come to that realization, to know that when you stand here to do anything, I've said many times so that any time any of you stand to do anything here, you're standing in the face of Christ.
Amen.
Jesus will never come down again to stand on this pulpit and preach salvation or preach the gospel or encourage you or sing for you. Anytime any of us stand, you stand in the capacity of Jesus Christ. And that's why you don't have to take it lightly when you are either dancing or singing or doing anything off the stage, because you are standing in the shoe of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are representing the heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let my eyes as we pray for Father, we thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord, for choosing us. Thank you, Lord, for making us to know that we are a royal priesthood, that we are a holy nation, that we are a chosen generation. Lord, this day, as we come to listen to your word, I pray that your word will have a fertile ground in every heart. Transform us from who we are, Lord, to who you want us to be. Father, cause us to see your work first in our lives, because your work is you. So if we put you first in our lives, every other thing will line up. Therefore, Father, I pray that your word as it comes forth today, may it correct, may it chastise, may it encourage, may it uplift us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Devil, we know you have no portion in this service because Jesus is present here.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord, because you are going to minister to us at the point of our needs. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
The youth chose a topic for the youth bash that transcended into today, which is you are born of royalty, or you are a royal priesthood. And that's what we'll be talking on today. I think last Sunday, while ministering at the baby dedication, which want to take this opportunity to thank everybody that was here to support us. Amen. God bless you for the cooking and all the drinks that you brought. We really appreciate that. Thank you so much. While we began last week, we began to look at the greatest creation, or the greatest of God's creation, which is the human being. Now I want us to step off from there to look at how precious, how important God has placed you and me. We know our text is 1 Peter chapter 2 from verse 9 and 10, but if you will look a little bit back to from verse 4 or verse 5, it begins there by telling us how Jesus came as the chief cornerstone, yet was rejected by men. And the chief cornerstone that was rejected by men became the real cornerstone. And the Bible makes us to understand that because of that, you and I are spiritual stones in the foundation of God. And looking at that critically, you ask yourself, why, how are we born of royalty? How are we born into royalty? How are we born of royalty, whichever way you want to put it? The Bible makes us to understand that when the children of Israel were held in bondage in Egypt, and they were asking God to release them for them to move or to go out of the bondage of the Egyptians, they had one thing in their mind. And that one thing was that they may go and worship the Lord. That they may go and worship the Lord. And when you look at what verse 9 of chapter 2 of 1 Peter begins, it says, but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood. Now listen to me very carefully. When they were crying out unto God in Egypt that save save us from our taskmasters, save us from the people that held us in bondage. The Bible said their desire was to go and worship God. And when they were released, the Bible says they worship the Lord in the wilderness. Now everybody was called to worship. Everybody was called to royalty. Everybody was called to a holy nation. By the time they left Egypt, there were a priest who unto the Lord. Now, before I go further, you need to understand who is a priest. And when the Bible says we are of the priesthood of royalty in God's house, what does God demand from us as a church or as individuals? The priest, as we know, is that one that stands between God and the people and man. He is in between the people and God. He hears from the people and takes it to God, and he hears from God and brings it to the people. In a nutshell, that was the function of the priest. So when the Bible says that you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, God is saying you resume responsibility in that position where you stand in the gap for the people and you bring it to God and you take the news from God and you bring it to the people. But this was not so when they left Egypt. When they left Egypt and they were in the wilderness, the Bible says that when they were worshiping, their aim was to go worship the Lord. Their aim was to be people that would worship and praise God. But something happened. Something happened. The Bible says, while in the wilderness, they began to indulge themselves into sinful acts. Different sinful acts that made God to say, I can no more listen to your worship. I can no more listen to your praise. Therefore, I have to set a tribe of Aaron to select from the tribe of Aaron Levites that will be set apart to bring me worship. Hallelujah. Now I want you to see very critically when God said you are now a holy nation, where we are coming from. Now, the priesthood was only from the tribe of Aaron, and all the Levites were those that conducted songs and praises and worship in the house of the Lord. It was no longer open for all the Israelites. They did not have right any longer to go into the presence of the Lord on their own to worship God, because of the sin nature and the sinful life that they were living. So God had to choose a particular tribe and said, everyone that comes out of this tribe must be trained to be a Levite and a priest in the house of God. Hallelujah. And when this happened, you can even remember the story when they left with the Ark of the Covenant. And the Bible said while they were going to Israel with the Ark of the Covenant, and the Levites that were holding the Ark of the Covenant stumbled to fall, and somebody that was not of the Levites tribe or the tribe of Aaron sent their hand to hold to support the Ark, he dropped dead. That was how serious it was if you were not of that tribe for you to touch the Ark of the Covenant. Now, all of these transcended through generations are waiting one man, awaiting the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the Bible says only after the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, when the Bible says on his crucifixion, on the day that he laid down his life for you and I, the Bible says that the curtain in the holiest of holy tore into two from top to bottom. A holy of holy was the place where only the priests and the Levites went in to praise God and to offer sacrifices or to offer prayer for the people. But the Bible says on that day that Jesus gave his life on the cross of Calvary for you and for me, that curtain that was sheltering people from seeing what was in the holiest of holies, tore from top to bottom, giving access for everybody to be able to see or to be able to have access into the holiest of holies.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thereby giving you and me the right.
Mm-hmm.
And that right had stayed hidden. In fact, I search other scriptures. I did a Bible search to see anywhere where this proclamation made by Peter here was made, or is made in the Bible. I didn't see any other place. So this was a deep revelation that was hidden from the church until God revealed it to Peter. That don't you understand that when you left Egypt with your desire to enter the promised land, all of you were Levites, all of you were accounted or were considered as the tribe of the Levites that had every right to worship God. And that is the same thing when you and I left Egypt. Hallelujah. When you left Egypt, when you left your Egypt, it was not the same way the children of Israel left their Egypt. You left your Egypt not with the blood of bulls and lambs, but with the blood of the Holy One of Israel, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So the Bible says, in their own era, sin could limit the people to be able to have access to the presence of the Lord. Now when sin limited them, a particular time had to be set aside. But from that time to the day that Jesus gave his life on the cross of Calvary, the Bible makes it clear that right from today, Peter declares, don't you know that you are now a holy nation? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's open your Bible now. Let you